Welcome to another episode of Turn the Qubits Off. This time we've got Michał Stęchwy, who's basically gonna try to do the same thing that we've been doing here for the last couple episodes. Michał has a blog called Musty Thoughts that I've actually covered in the channel. I definitely recommend you guys go and check it out. Especially my favorite part in here is the stuff that he's been doing with QAOA and VQE. Where is that here? So really good stuff, definitely. Michał has got a lot of other projects in there. I guess if you browse the blog, I mean, definitely subscribe. But if you browse the... Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff, career culture, open source. There's a bunch of other things here that are also interesting. That's not your, it's not just about quantum computing concepts, but it's a bit more on everything that has to do with his career as well. So I think it's really cool. And oh yeah, here, I think it's linked to his GitHub. He's got some projects that I've also covered before. Some really good tutorials. There's a lot of stuff in here. He's doing a lot of things for the Unitary Fund as well. I think there's been, he's working also in some quantum environmental stuff. But anyway, just go ahead and take a look at Michał. I think it's going to be fun. It's going to be a fun one.
Hello, my name is Michał Stęchwy, and Daniel from Quantum Intuition asked me to solve a quantum puzzle here. So the goal of this puzzle is to turn all the qubits off. And, well, as you can see, it is probably this is something that like creates the quantum state. Here we see the probabilities of on being measured. And we would like to get all of them down to 0%. I've never used this, how to call this? Like Quirk simulator. So, well, I have to kind of accustom myself with the interface, but okay, let's see what happens. So if I add Z, nothing happens here or here or here. If I add Y, okay, something happens. Actually, there are like two ways to... Oh, there is Xgate, okay. There are two ways to actually solve this puzzle. So I can either change all the states to zero, or I can change all the states to one and then just like flip them over. Okay, so what do we have here? Here we have Hadamard. Okay, so we can easily turn this off using Hadamard. And to turn these off, okay, Hadamard won't do the job. Okay, so it seems that on the first qubit, we just had like a simple Hadamard. And just like applying it again turns it off. However, on these qubits, it seems that there's like some rotation by some angle. Hard to say what angle exactly, but let's just... Okay, so if we do Y gate, it flips the probability. Yeah, like, so it adds like 85.4 IATs with 14.6 to 100. So it seems like Y is flipping the state. And it seems that Z is not doing anything. Also, like perhaps these two gates, they might be somehow entangled, but no idea. Okay, so let's look what we can do with the quarter turns. Probably this should affect it. No, it's not. Oh, good. So, okay, so 1/2 x. Is changing this state to 50. So now we have 50, so let's try Hadamard. Okay, Hadamard is not helping us too much. So let's try it. Well, just like try it again. Okay. Again, 50. Okay, so I think we are, oh yeah, like, so, well, actually, yeah, applying two half x's, one after each another, should be the same as applying one x. So yeah, this totally makes sense. So I think it requires some combination of x and y gate. What this is doing? It's principal square root and adjoint square root. So actually, this transforms 0 into plus 1 plus 1 half I, 0 plus 1 plus 1 half I 1, and this adds minus to the 0. Okay, so how this affect it? Okay, so it changes it to 85.4, and this doesn't seem to affect the state. Okay, so let's see how this gates works. Okay, so this one, so half x changes to 50-50, half x changes to adjoint, like half square root, yeah, basically, of adjoint square root, oh, that's the name, of not changes is to also 50-50. Okay, and let's see how the fourth works. Okay. Well, so we have, it seems like there is something ongoing on with the complex imaginary parts of the, yeah, t is not doing anything, with the numbers. No idea. Okay, so let's think. If we do this, we get into 25 of having on. So this probably, to solve this puzzle, we probably need some combination of x and y gates. But what combination and why this? No idea. So right now I'm trying just to blindly throw different gates and see if I can solve it by sheer luck. But I guess it's not the most effective approach. Again, Hadamard. Okay. Yeah, so I think we need to kind of figure out what's the actual state behind all this. Okay, so this is some fraction, okay, some fraction of rotation, and it seems that there is some complex part involved in here, because, you know, we see that this has different effect as from this, right? So it seems that using adjoint square root of y doesn't really affect probabilities here. Okay, so it rotates, oh yeah, block sphere is probably good way to think about it. So it rotates minus 90 degree around the y-axis. So, and this one rotates 90 degrees around y-axis. So our qubit probably is, our qubit is probably rotated around both y and x axis, because like the z kind of the z rotations didn't look like they are affecting it at all. Okay, so what state would so this rotation around y for 90 degrees So there are like some states that this is this one is not actually. Let's try this one. Is it? Oh, nice. I just turned it off. Oh, this one not as well. Okay, but we solved the first one, and we can say, oh, I turned all of them off. So yeah, I have no idea. I mean, it was just sheer luck. So basically, it seems that we have Hadamard here and Hadamard there. So these like first two on like first and last wire, we have Hadamards, and in here we have just principal fourth root of y, which we have to undo, and then principal fourth root of x, which we also have to undo. So it is basically rotation, just like one rotation which we have to do in the other direction. Well, it was fun. I hope you enjoyed watching as I struggle with figuring it out. If you I have a blog where I write about quantum computing, Musty Thoughts. If you like, you can visit it. And have a nice day.
So that was Michal. I hope you enjoyed watching him trying to go through the little puzzle. And again, once more, just a couple of thoughts about a couple of words about his blog. Go visit, subscribe. It's a really nice blog. It's really nice blog, and I really I mean, you've seen it probably in my channel before because I've covered some of those stuff, some of the things that are in here. So definitely go check it out. And stay tuned for more Turn the Qubits Off shows coming up on Monday every week. Yeah, I don't know. I guess once I run out of people, I'll just stop, but it's just fun. Cool. See you next time.